Learn how the Laboratory of Environmental Hygiene and Forensic Toxicology addresses a growing number of police seizures using Malin GCMS and high-resolution accurate mass LCMS. As one of the reference laboratories for judicial and healthcare institutions in the northern part of Italy, the laboratory analyzes more than 10,000 seized samples annually.
In addition to traditional drugs of abuse, seized substances increasingly include designer drugs and new psychoactive substances for which certified reference materials are not always available. Analysis of seized substances involves several workflow steps. These include sample receipt, inspection and preparation, instrumental analysis and quality control, data analysis, interpretation, and reporting. The methods used must be fully validated prior to their application for forensic cases, with particular attention to sampling and analytical uncertainties. The workflow begins when seized substances are received. The goals are to prevent alteration, contamination, or any loss of materials which are unique evidences of judicial cases, establish and maintain chain of custody, and ensure the security of materials and sensitive information within the framework of penal proceedings. A password-protected file is created, and the sample is assigned a unique ID. The date, time, source of the evidence, and the physical description, including packaging, weight, color, odor, and other important physical characteristics, are recorded. Visual inspection or morphological examination using optical and electron microscopy techniques may help distinguish known from unknown substances. Because seized substances are often very heterogeneous, sampling is done with utmost care according to the size of sampling targets, number of items in a single batch of seizures, physical characteristics of the items, such as bulk, powder, or traces, and similarities between items. Representative sample is crushed and pulverized into fine-grained particles to reduce sampling uncertainty. Preliminary colorimetric assays, or FTIR spectroscopy, are used to check for adulterants and diluents. Samples are then extracted using solid-liquid extraction. Liquid-liquid extraction is mainly used in the case of heroin, amphetamines, cocaine, and methadone solutions. Internal standard is added for assay control. For better GCMS results, samples may be derivatized. Samples are then ready to load into the instrument for analysis. Identification and quantification of illicit ingredients are obtained mainly by chromatographic and mass spectrometric techniques. For routine analysis of target ingredients, GCMS, with or without derivatization, is used for confirmation. In order to obtain accurate quantitation of illicit substances, samples were also quantified using GCFID. According to law, accurate quantitation of illicit active ingredients in seized drugs is important in order to discern between possession for healthcare versus recreational purposes. Confirmation and quantification are carried out using reference materials when they are available.
Because of the relentless growth in new psychoactive substances, leading forensic toxicology labs like the Laboratory of Environmental Hygiene and Forensic Toxicology are moving to high-resolution accurate mass LCMS workflows. LC, coupled with high-resolution accurate mass thermoscientific orbitrap mass spectrometer technology, provides several unique benefits which allow us to identify and quantify traditional and new illicit drugs with greater speed and confidence. High-res accurate mass and full scan capabilities capture all sample data all the time, allowing retrospective data analysis to be performed without repeating experiments.
The chromatographic resolution provided by high-resolution accurate mass instruments minimizes the effects of coelution on ion suppression. Ultra-high accurate mass measurements also provide insights about a substance's elemental composition. Moreover, the very high resolving power of the high-resolution MS system allows comparison of the experimental and calculated fine structure of the molecular ion isotopic peaks, enabling assignment of elemental formulae to seized drugs. Finally, to aid in structural characterization, compounds with the same elemental composition are subjected to MS-MS to obtain characteristic product ions. Because unreliable results could be contested in court or lead to poor legal outcomes, quality control is required. Internal reports are used to check data integrity. validate analytical results, and provide a summary about the case and its samples. Ultimately, a final report is delivered to the law enforcement agency. Because law enforcement may request further investigation and presentation of information in court, all data concerning the forensic analyses are archived and secured. With HRAM and full scan capabilities that capture all sample data all the time, retrospective data analysis can be performed without repeating experiments.